All right, so now you understand how a sample app with a list view and custom array adapter work. So that's a great starting point for understanding how we can make the corresponding changes in our app. Now, the Android Flavor app had two text views and one image view per list item. In the case of our Miwok app, we'll want to have two text views. And this is why we'll need to create a custom array adapter, because the default one only works with a single text view. So let's start with step one of the quiz. First, we asked you to create a list of word objects. And here's the code for the array list of word objects. Notice that each word object created has an English and Miwok translation pair. So make sure the order of the inputs is English word first, and then Miwok word. And remember, that's because that's how we set it up in the word constructor here. Now back in the numbers activity, we asked you to modify the way that the adapter was created and set it on the list view. So we provided some code for you that you could add to the numbers activity to make sure that the word adapter was built correctly. So we had you remove the old array adapter code, and then the onCreate method would look like this. So here we're creating a new word adapter object and storing it in a variable called adapter. We're calling the constructor and passing in a context. So that's what this refers to. It refers to the numbers activity. And then passing in the array list of word objects. Then we're finding the list view in the layout with ID called lists, and then setting the adapter on it. Now for the third step, we asked you to create a new word adapter class. And we showed you the instructions for how to do this in the earlier video. For the fourth step, we modified the class declaration so that the word adapter extends or inherits from the array adapter class. So by specifying the word class as a generic parameter here, we expect that the array adapter's data source be the list of word objects. Now in the fifth step, we asked you to override the getView method to provide your own implementation of the method. So this code here was generated by Android Studio. You could have either used the keyboard shortcut, Control-O, or gone up here to code override method and selected getView method. So for step six, we asked you to complete this method with your own implementation and pointed you to the Android Flavor app as an example. So let me open up the Android Flavor app. Here's the code for the Android Flavor adapter in the custom array adapter example. So down here is its getView method. Since this logic is very similar to the getView method we need in our Miwok app, let's just copy and paste this section over into our code. So I just pasted that code into the word adapter class. First, we're making sure that we have a list item view, even if it doesn't have the right data. So we could try to use the recycled view that came in as an input parameter. However, it is possible that it could be null, meaning that there's no view to reuse. In this case, we would need to inflate one from the list item layout from scratch. We can use the layout inflator from Android and call the inflate method, passing in the layout resource ID, the parent view, which is the list view, and false here, because we don't want to attach the list item view to the parent list view just yet. The next step is that we'll need to find the word object at the requested position so we can start to set the appropriate data onto the views in that layout. So we'll call the getItem method, which comes from the superclass ArrayAdapter, and it takes in as its input the desired position. Now, instead of returning an Android flavor object, we'd like this getItem to return a word object. And this is because our class declaration says that we inherit from ArrayAdapter, where word is the return type of the getItem method. Let's take a look at the documentation for the getItem method. So here's the documentation for the getItem method from the ArrayAdapter class. So in this case, we can substitute the word data type anywhere that we see the generic parameter t. Let's head back to the code. Now for these next three sections, we don't have an image view in our layout just yet, so we can delete these lines of code related to setting an image on the image view. Let's navigate over to the list item XML layout. Remember that we have two text views within here, one with the view ID called Miwok text view, and one with the view ID called default text view. And note, it might be slightly different in your code if you chose to name them differently. This means that back in the word adapter class, the list item view variable is currently referencing the root linear layout for the list item layout. So if we call the findViewById method on the list item view, then we can find the Miwok text view. And once we find that, we can cast the view to a text view, because it is a text view, and then go ahead and store it in a Miwok text view variable. After that, we can call the setText method on the text view, and then pass in the new text that needs to be displayed. So this would be the Miwok translation string from the current word object. So reading this line of code can be a little bit complex, but let's just start by reading the expression within the parentheses first. So on the current word object, we call the method getMiWokTranslation. So this returns a string that's a Miwok word, and that becomes the input to the setText method call on the miWokTextView object. So now the miWokTextView should display the miWok word. We will repeat the same steps for the default text view. So the list item view points to the linear layout in the list item layout. So we'll call findViewById to search all its children. We find the view with the ID defaultTextView and cast it to a text view. And then we'll store it in a variable called defaultTextView. After that, on the current word object, we'll call the getDefaultTranslation method. And this helps us get the English translation string. Now this becomes the input to the setText method call on the defaultTextView object. So now the defaultTextView should display the English word. Now with all that done, we just need to return the list item view as a return value. So the list view will take its return value and add it as a child to itself. Phew, that was really challenging, but thanks for hanging in there. So to recap, in our getView method, we first get a list item view that we can use. So either by reusing one that was given to us or inflating a new one completely from scratch. Then we get the word object at the given position. And after that, we can start finding the views in the list item layout and setting data onto them from the word object. And lastly, we can return the updated list item view. So let's try to run the code now. It looks like there's an error in the numbers activity. It says that there's an error with creating the word adapter. So that's because we forgot to create the constructor in the word adapter. Remember that it takes two inputs, the contacts and list of words. So let's go ahead and do that now. Let's take a look at the example in the flavor adapter app. We described the constructor earlier in the last video, so you can refer back to it if we need it. So here I am back again looking at the example flavor app. So we described the constructor earlier in the last video, so you can refer back to that if needed. Now we're going to need something similar to this for our word adapter. So I'm going to copy and paste this constructor over and then tweak it. So at the top of the word adapter class, I'm going to paste that constructor we copied over. Now instead of Android flavor adapter, we need it to be word adapter, because remember the constructor name needs to match the class name. Also inside this list here, instead of a list of Android flavors, we want a list of words. And lastly, inside this constructor, we can call the superclass Android adapters constructor by passing in the context, the layout resource ID, and then the list of objects. So we'll need to update this to words as well. Remember that we can pass in 0 for the layout resource ID here, because we're inflating the layout ourselves in the getView method. Here's what the app looks like on our device. So navigating into the numbers activity. Nice. So the list is showing the Miwok and English words. So congratulations. Really great work.